So hello students, hope you are doing well. So in this lecture we'll be starting a new concept, that is multi-threading in Java. Okay, so as you all know that multi-threading is a very important concept and it is a very important feature in Java programming language. So we have divided this into three categories, that what is multi-threading, why it is useful, this is the objective, that why is it useful, and how many threads till now we have created in our programs. Okay, so before going into multi-threading, we must have a basic idea on multitasking. As the name suggests, multitask, it means that more than one task is being executed simultaneously. Okay, more than one task is being executed. Okay, so we can say that multitasking is a state of executing more than one task simultaneously at a time. So can you give some real life examples of multitasking? Can you just think of any example in which you can depict multitasking is being taking place? So here are some examples. Okay, you are the best example of multitasking. Okay, students are the best example of multitasking. For example, I am just teaching you in this mode, and at the same time you are listening to me. Okay, there might be a condition that you are thinking something else. Okay, you are memorizing the things that I am just briefing, you are visualizing the concepts, you are correlating the things in your mind, and might be you are also busy watching something like TV, or you are watching the surroundings. Okay, you may be busy in listening some songs also, it can also happen. Okay, if you are not focusing on this particular lecture. So this is basically a same person, is dedicating to different tasks. Okay, a same person, at the same time is in different modes, you can see. So this is a multitasking. Okay, one task, you are performing at a time different tasks. Okay, so we have broadly categorized this multitasking into two categories. This multitasking is again being divided into two categories. Okay, so the first is the process based multitasking, and the second is the thread based multitasking. So before going into multi-threading, we must be aware of what multitasking is. Okay, multitasking is basically a superset of multi-threading. Okay, this multi-threading belongs to this multitasking. So we will just go into the process based multitasking. So as you all know that multitasking is a feature in which more than one task can be performed simultaneously at a time. So process based multitasking means that you can perform many jobs, or you can perform many tasks, execute many tasks simultaneously. Okay, simultaneous executions of tasks or jobs, are taking place, in which each job belongs to a separate independent process. This line is very important. Each job is a separate independent process now. Okay, you are just running different jobs, and now each job is a process. Okay, if for example, if you are writing a program, you are writing a program in Java or any IDE, so that writing a program is a process. Okay, at the same time you are listening to something, listening to music, so the listening to music is a process. Okay, you are for example downloading some assignments, from the Google Drive, so downloading assignments is a process. Okay, and for example you are uploading the assignments, so uploading assignments is a process, and so on. Okay, and so on. So these are different processes. Okay, these are separate independent processes, okay, that you are performing. So process based multitasking means that different tasks are in a state of simultaneous execution, where each task is a separate independent process. Okay, so you have to just care of you have to just take care of this word separate independent process. So the examples of such type of multitasking are all the processes that belongs to the operating system level. Okay, all the processes that are in the scope of operating system, all those belongs to operating system are known as process based multitasking. For example, you can say there is a client of yours and he has given you a task that you have to perform this particular project in some time frame. Okay, so your client just asks you that what is your requirement. So you will say that my requirement is, I need this type of dependencies. Okay, if there is this type of dependency in my program, then what will happen? Okay, you don't ask your client, or you don't say to your client that my requirement is that I will be playing a game in the background. Okay, I'll be listening the music. Okay, I'll be watching the movie. So this is not the requirement of your client. Okay, this is not the requirement. Okay, this all belongs to the operating system level. Okay, where the client is, where there is no interaction between you and your client. Okay, the interaction is in thread based model. Okay, so this model is independent of any client. Okay, so in this you are not going into programmatical mode. Okay, no programmable level is there in this, only operating system level is there. Okay, so in thread based multitasking, okay, it simply means that there are n number of, let us say, n number of jobs or n number of tasks, and there is no dependency between the tasks. Okay, it means that all the tasks are independent of each other. Okay, and each task is a separate part of the same process. Okay, so in the previous process based multitasking, there were different processes that were executing. Okay, but in thread based multitasking, there is a single process. Okay, remember, there is a single process, and inside these single process, there are multiple sub processes that are executing, and these multiple sub processes or these multiple parts, okay, of the processes are independent. Okay, they are independent of each other. Okay, so that's why it is written here that separate or independent part of the same process. Okay, so all the sub processes that belongs to a particular process, that are executing in isolation, that are executing concurrently, that are not disturbing the flow of each other, are known as thread based models, or they fall into the category of thread based multitasking. Okay, so the thread based multitasking is also known as programmable level multitasking. Okay, so all the programming level processes, okay, are the examples of thread based multitasking. So each independent part, okay, the part that is independent, that is that sub process, that is known as a thread. Okay, this part that belongs to a process, okay, it is now known as a thread. Okay, so there can be n number of threads in a single process, okay, that are executing simultaneously without affecting each other, that are running concurrently. Okay, so now we can see this particular concept of, okay, thread based multitasking with the help of a figure. Okay, consider this is a block, this is a process block, okay, that contains a program. For example, and a program contains certain statements. So for example, this particular process block has 50,000 lines of code, and 20,000 lines of code is dedicated to this particular block, 20,000 lines of code is dedicated to this particular block, and the rest lines of code is dedicated to the remaining blocks. Okay, so this particular block, this first block that contains the 20,000 lines of code, is independent of this second block that contains the 20,000 lines of code. So both of these blocks are independent of each other. Both of these blocks don't have any programmable dependency. Okay, they don't depend on each other's execution. They are running concurrently in isolation. Okay, so we can say that we can give this particular statement, okay, we can designate this particular line of code, this particular block, to a specific thread that is known as a thread one, whose responsibility is to execute these lines, these particular block. Okay, so this particular block is designated with the help of a thread t1. Similarly, this particular block is designated with the thread t2. So both of these threads, t1 and t2, are the part of a same process, that is process p. Okay, and both of these threads are independent of each other. Okay, these are the part of the process, these are the sub processes, these are independent of each other. Okay, these particular threads are running concurrently, there is no dependency, as a result of which your program, okay, the execution time is less. Okay, you are giving the CPU maximum efficiency, your CPU is now more efficient. If for example Your whole code is designated to this process, and this process is not being divided into certain tasks, then what will happen? Okay, your program will take, for example, your program is taking 10 seconds for execution. Okay, but when we have just divided this program into number of threads, then each thread is concurrently executing in parallel mode, okay, simultaneously, as a result of which the execution time, the response time is decreased. Okay, so the response time is decreased. For example, now it is coming 1 second or 1 millisecond. Okay, so it means that the processor can do some other useful work in the remaining time. Okay, so here it is written that both threads T1 and T2 are executing simultaneously and are independent part of the same block P. Okay, so why we use threads? This is the question, why we use threads. So as we all know that thread is a lightweight process, it means it is the part of a process, and it is also known as a sub process. That's why it is said it is a lightweight process. So it is a part of the same process that is executing in isolation. Okay, that is executing concurrently without disturbing the other thread's flow. It utilizes maximum power of the CPU. Okay, so CPU, for example, if we have designated the whole program to a single core of the processor, then this single core is busy in executing this particular code, and it will obviously take more time. So when we designate n number of threads to different cores of the processor, then the degree of parallelism will be high, and as a result of which your CPU will be more efficient and utilize the maximum power. Okay, so the processor will be busy, okay, as there are n number of threads and each threads are executing in different cores of the processor. That means that the CPU is now very busy in executing these threads. That improves the performance of the CPU because it is busy. It results in high throughput. Okay, throughput means the number of jobs or the number of tasks that are executing per unit time. Okay, so if there are, let us suppose, 4 cores, okay, if there are quad core system, okay, in the processor, then each core is dedicated to certain thread, and independently these threads are executing in different cores, resulting in the efficiency or high throughput of the processor. Okay, so it provides high degree of parallelism. Okay, because this shows that now the parallel computing is now into picture. Okay, as parallel architecture we are just maintaining. Okay, we are framing a parallel architecture with the help of these threads. So here we have depicted a processor. Okay, this is a processor, and there are, for example, different cores in this processor. So this is example of quad core, for example. Okay, there are 4 cores, and we have designated, okay, different threads to each of these cores, so that each core of this processor is now busy in executing the thread, resulting in less response time. Okay, the response time will now be decreased, the execution time will be decreased, as a result of which the efficiency of the processor will be increased, because the processor is not idle now. Okay, it is in a continuous processing. Okay, we are maximizing the output, we are maximizing the processor's capability. Okay, the computing power of the capability we are maximizing. Okay, so till now we have worked only one thread. In the past we have created certain programs in which we have created only one thread, and we are dependent only the single thread. Okay, the thread is the main thread. As you have seen in the exceptions, when the exceptions are arised, okay, then you have seen exception in thread main java dot lang dot arithmetic exception type of, okay, exceptions. Okay, so in this you have noticed that it is written exception in thread main. Okay, so there is a single thread that is main because it is constituting our that particular program. Okay, we have not created different threads, we are just relying on the single thread that is main. Okay, so hope your concepts are a bit cleared now in multitasking. Okay, so revise this. Okay, there are different types of multitasking. The multitasking is being divided into two: process based, thread based. Process based means there are different processes that are executing simultaneously. Okay, and thread based means all the particular threads or all the particular sub processes belongs to a single process, belongs to a same program, but they are in isolation, they are independent of each other, they are independent part of the program. Okay, so stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.